royal watchers are losing their minds, apparently, because Prince Harry and Meghan Markle have announced that they're stepping back from their royal duties. What?
This was everyone yesterday.
They say they want to focus on raising their family and their charity work and split their time between the UK and North America. Why is everyone flipping out?
Yeah.
Well, can I just say one thing? That it's a relief to be talking about this because we thought we were in World War III yesterday.
Right, right.
This is on circles. This is World War III.
But this is actually a fun topic. Yeah. Compared to what we've been talking about all
every
week, in my opinion, yeah. I was scared all week.
Yeah.
This doesn't scare me.
But you know what? I don't think this is so fun for Prince Harry
for them?
And for a family.
I
don't think we have all the details, and that'll
sure.
probably, I'm sure it'll trickle out because there's nothing we love talking about more than the royals.
Mm-hmm.
But watching The Crown, every single episode, I say to my husband, being a royal seems miserable.
Yeah.
It's like against everything that I want as a human being. You don't mm-hmm. have the freedom. You got to be kind of cold as ice. Mm-hmm. You can't always love who you want to love. And who knows what Prince Harry's been through over the years. I mean, he lost his mom at a young age, and
yeah.
it has followed them their entire life. She lost her life around with the press.
Then why do they always want to go back? They always go back.
Where? To the royals?
To the royals. I mean, remember the guy, you don't know, but years ago, I mean, I'm the oldest person in the room, probably. But there was an abdication at some point during World War II
yes.
by Edward and his wife, Wallis Simpson, who was an American.
Yeah. Oh, that's what you're asking.
And he did want to
and,
go
well,
back.
And they all they begged to go back.
Because the same reason people beg to come back to the show. It's power. You know? Well, yeah. You
relevance.
Know, whenever it's relevance, it's all this stuff. People want to be in the know. Listen. These two people, she is not British. She's
no.
an American girl. She's
yeah,
like,
yeah.
look, I don't mind. I married a prince. I love you. I know you're a prince. But, you know, this is too much for me.
Yeah.
yeah.
We can't do, I'm not interested in doing this. I don't mind if we go back and forth. But we're, this isn't the sole focus. And you're not going to be king.
No,
well, you're not going to be king. So what are we hanging for?
That's a big part of it. I was
let's go to Canada.
I was sort of surprised yesterday that so many people were so offended and shocked. And I started looking at some of the headlines
uh-huh.
about Meghan, and the Daily Mail had this headline: "Is Meghan's favorite snack fueling drought and murder?" And they were talking about the fact that she likes avocado toast. Then the Sun said, "Meghan
Nonsense.
Made cake cry." The Sun, another headline was, "Princess pushy. Meghan is shallow. They're royal hypocrites." So, and those same outlets are now saying, why would she leave? Well, I mean, you know, it was sort of this unprecedented racism and this unprecedented hatred towards her. And the palace, in my view, didn't come out and protect her in the way that we've sort of seen them protect others in the family. And so you think about someone that's being criticized relentlessly like that, with no protection from
well, her
husband, family,
her
other than her husband.
Her husband was protecting
why not
her,
please?
And he's saying, you know, I'm not going to be the king. What you want to do, baby?
And right. you know what else?
She said, let's go somewhere where we can have some fun, we can do some charity work, I can
mm-hmm.
go back to doing what I like doing and raise our baby, Archie. Are you okay with that? And he's like, listen,
I love
I got to take care of some stuff
mm-hmm.
because, you know, this is part of my thing.
Yep.
But, yeah, we're going somewhere else where we're going to have our life. And they'll do what they need to do.
Hi,
well, you
Bob Ryan, can we have them co-host here on Friday?
I would love
are
that.
They available?
Yes.
No, but you know what?
It's
it was one joke, you guys.
Possible.
Don't
hey, you know
be
what?
We never
thought this was going to happen, and it has.
Yeah.
That's why we're so fascinated by it. But the one thing that's changed for Prince Harry in 2 years, you think about it, he got married
yeah.
to an American,
mm-hmm.
and he had a child.
Yes.
And if there's one thing we can all agree on at the stable, is like when you have a child,
mm-hmm.
things change.
Yes.
Things
they
that
do.
You're willing to put up with,
yes.
things
mm-hmm.
that you are willing to just do
say
day
it,
in,
Abby.
Day out,
say it.
You don't do it anymore.
Yeah.
Because
no.
you care about something so much more than you care about yourself.
Yep.
You care about your child. You
right.
want to give them the best life you possibly
that's
can.
Right.
So that's why I say, I know some people are saying it's all Meghan's fault. I'm not buying that.
No.
I actually say, good for you guys. If this is what you have to do for yourself and for your family, then do. Make
then,
that
then,
decision.
Then
make
you
that
do
decision
it.
For you.
Speak
then
on
you
it.
Do it. And you know, Abby, to your point, I really remember Abby said on the show I'm saying Abby said on the show, what was that interview, ITV News, when Meghan was broke down and was crying?
Meghan Markle.
She broke down crying and she said, you know, you're the first person that's asked me how I feel. And I remember you said during that show, you said, wow, you know, she's really feeling it. And as a new mom yourself,
she got criticized for even saying that. She got criticized for saying, thank you for asking me if I'm okay.
She's going to be criticized for anything she does. It's just the way it is. Yeah. They're the royals. They will work it out. Uh-huh. Y'all just take a deep breath.
Yeah.
There's something about a lot. There's a certain naivete for some people who get into the royal family, though, I think.
I don't think she was naive.
I mean, Princess Diana, for instance, was very naive.
But Harry, was naive.
Rest her soul.
But Harry is very clear.
Yeah.
It's why he came out from the giddy up and said, stop messing with my wife.
But do you think
Stop saying this stuff.
What this entails.
Nobody knows until they're in it.
Yeah.
Like, I think much that's like this point, show. Right?
Well,
you don't know.
Oh,
until you are in the heat of everything.
Can you ring that again?
Well, everybody.
Pardon my backside. I'm sorry.
You know, we were all raised with Cinderella. We've all seen the Disney movie Cinderella. Mm-hmm. You marry the handsome prince, and that's the end of the movie. They don't tell you what happens after the pumpkin sort of shrivels up.
Yeah.
That's a great point. They need a sequel.